Hello guys, it's Simple YouTube Guy, and today I've got the weirdest fucking puppet you can find at McDonald's. At McDonald's they have this puppet thing. It's not really a puppet, but it is a puppet, but it ain't really a puppet. So you got your, I guess you could say you have a puppet button with a happy face on it. You got your twist it. You got your pull it. You got your spin it, which is on the left this time instead of the right, and pull it is a bit different. And then you got your switch it. Now the way this game works is, as you can see, it's not electric, so it's not an electronic game. It's more of the, let's say, it's a toy, okay? It's more like either it can be a fidget toy or it can be a game. So I choose it to be a fidget toy for now. But how you would normally play is there's a dice. See? Let's grab the instruction card. Yes. There are instructions. It's just like a playing card. It's not really that bad. This is what I assume it would say. It would probably say something along the lines of, for one or more players to play the game, this is what you do. Now, I'll show you what you do. So it's like Simon Says. So you do one command, you roll the dice, which it has a dice, but it's broken. The dice ripped somehow. But what you would normally do, you don't even need the dice. In fact, if you have a ripped dice, you don't really need it. All you gotta do is just call out commands. You can do like verbal, like the actual boppy. You can do, if you say bop it, you can choose an action. Like, let's say if you're a blind person, you don't need the dice. If you're blind, you don't need the dice. But what if other people want it? Then what you would do is you would, if your dice is broken, you can, well, if it doesn't work, if it broke while you were trying to assemble it, you can do one of the following. One, you can literally just verbally say the commands, like on the real bop it, like, for example, if I were to say bop it, the instructions say you can choose any action you want if you say bop it, or if it lands on bop it, the dice, if you're doing it visually. Now, for example, if I said twist it, or if it landed on bop it, and I choose twist it, then if it landed on, let's say, switch it, then I do twist it and switch it. You see what I'm saying? So, let's practice. Let's say if I said spin it, then I'd spin it, twist it, pull it, bop it. I could probably hit this if I really wanted to. Okay, so let's do this. If you mess up, it doesn't do anything. All you do is just start over. It's for one or more players, obviously. But I'd rather stick to the solo because there's no settings or anything. There's just, like, you know, not really anything cool about this boppet unless you're a real boppet person and you really, really want to do this. So basically what it centers around is a circle. It's like just a round circle, about almost 4 inches in length. The spin it is on the left side of the circle. The top left, switch it is on the top right, pull it is on the bottom right, and twist it is on the bottom left. Now, something about twist it, normally when you twist the twist it knob, which is yellow, when you twist it, it usually goes back into place, right? But this one, you have to put it back yourself. So let's say if you add it here, and you twist it, it doesn't go into place. you have to put it back. So you have to manually do it. You have to manually do it. It's not bad, but yeah, whatever. It's a cheap plastic poppet for about not even $1.50. It's that cheap. No, really. I think it has the happy face in the middle, but yet I think it also has the boppet. You know, I think the boppet is more on this side or on this side, I think. Well, you know what? It has the happy face on it, so whatever. So, for example, let's go to the actual gameplay. What you would do, since it's not really electronic, like I said, you use a dice. Now, if you don't have a dice that's actually, like, you know, usable, if your dice ripped while putting it together, which that happened to me, if it rips and doesn't work anymore, you can make your own dice, you know. All you have to do is copy what's on the dice, on the actual dice, and put it on your own dice. And, maybe they should have just put a plastic dice. What do you think? I mean, I think that McDonald's should have just put a plastic dice in there instead of making it to where people try not to, like, you know, do anything. And besides, the dice is visual, so it doesn't really work out for me because I'm blind. So basically what I would do is for example, if it landed on twist it, or if someone said twist it, I'd twist it. If it said pull it, I not only do the command, but I'd do the command before it. So let's do twist it again and then pull it. But if it said spin it, then I'd twist it, pull it, and spin it. So, let's say if it landed on boppet. Let's say if I wanted to hit the boppet interface. You can do that. You can choose any action, but I'd rather do, like, the normal way. Now, if you're, like, the boppet command, the boppet freak you are, if you guys are the boppet freaks you are, then you can do it like the normal gameplay if you wanted to. But it won't be verbal because it doesn't have any electronics in it. You can say, bop it, twist it, pull it, spin it, switch it, switch it, twist it, twist it, spin it, bop it, pull it, pull it, bop it, spin it, twist it. Or you can do it the way that the game says, and you can say, twist it, pull it, spin it, switch it, spin it, see? Now if you mess up, let's say if I did another command, pull it. But let's say I didn't pull it and I switched it instead. Now that would mean I messed up and then I would have to start over again. Oh. No. These commands are in a totally different place. So you can do it like the normal gameplay if you really, really wanted to. And that's what I think I'm going to do. So, to end up this video, I'm actually going to do it like a normal bop it. So, let's bop it to start. Bop it. Twist it. Pull it. Spin it. Switch it. Twist it. Twist it. Pull it. Pull it. Bop it. Spin it. Flick it. Switch it, whatever. Whatever. But, I mean, I'm just saying, you do have the option. if you really, really, really wanted to, and you are so into Bop It, like in the normal electronic game, Bop It, then you can. Oh, look, they actually have the classic pull it handle and the classic twist it and the classic spin it from 2011. And the flick it handle is turning to switch it. I mean, if you really, really wanted to, you can play like the normal Bop It if you wanted to. Like, let's say, the game, the way, like, say that if you're a blind person and you can't play the game like the normal way, you can say to yourself, Bop It, twist it, pull it, spin it, switch it, switch it. Spin it, twist it, bop it, pull it, you know what I'm saying. Now, compared to the regular Bop It, I'm going to grab a real Bop It to show you. I'm going to grab one that feels exactly almost like it. You see, this is a McDonald's Bop It. This is a normal Bop It.
Beep bop, solo, box bop, beep bop, box bop, solo.
Mind you, I used the Bop It extreme for this. Now, what you can do, I mean, if you really, really wanted to, you can play it like the normal game, like Bop It to start. Bop It, twist it, pull it, spin it. Flick it. I mean, switch it, whatever. I'm so used to flicking, you know. And you know what? This could give you a chance to do good on voice acting. You don't actually have to play it like the normal game, the way that the game says. You know what? You can just do it like you really, really want to. Like, you can practice your voice acting skills, or you can fidget with it, or you can just, you can make noise with it or something. You can do something good. I mean, this thing has no electronics whatsoever, but it does have mechanics in it. And the spinning feels a little bit like I mean, seriously, you can do what the normal gameplay. In fact, I'll do it again. You know, you can pull it to activate it. You can pretend this is a regular Bop It, and you can pull it and see if it'll, like, you know, activate, and then you can Bop It, pretend you're bopping it, and you can also thing them in your head. You can just I mean, seriously, if you really wanted to, you can do that. Like, seriously, you can say it out loud, or you can not say it, like beep-bop, or you can, like, seriously, you can literally just think them in your head, and you know what you can also do? In the way of bebop, you can, yeah, seriously, you can do that. I mean, as you can see, it is a toy, and it is still bopping. But you really can't do much with it. But you can pretend like you're playing it like a normal bop-it, like you can... Excuse me. And with this, I'm out!